think about my beautiful wreath here? How would you like to learn how to make one? Well, I just stole this off of Gail's door, and I know she's going to want it back. But luckily, she's here today to teach us how to make this wreath and to get hers back. Hi, Gail. Merry Christmas.
Hi. Merry Christmas, Rhonda. Yes, this is just such a really neat time of the year. I wish that you could all be here in this kitchen with us today. We're having so much fun making all these neat things. But the smell of Christmas is in the air with all the fresh pine that we have here.
Well, I'm really excited to learn how to make this wreath, Gail, so show me some of the things that we're going to need to get started.
All right. Well, first of all, what you're going to need to get started is a ring, and you can pick this up, Rhonda, at any craft store, and also a spool of wire. Now, I have already attached the wire to the ring, and this is going to be our first step of making this wreath.
Okay, great. I see you have all these little clusters here.
Yes, absolutely. You know, you can put any kind of greens in a wreath that you like, boxwood, you know, anything like that. Juniper looks really pretty. Holly looks really pretty in wreaths. We are going to make a country wreath today, so I decided just to go with the pine. So basically what you need to have, Rhonda, is a pair of clippers in your car at all times during the month of December. You could go into the woods to find your pine. It's a really neat thing to do with your kids. You could go on a hike, you can gather your pine, you can carry a really cool basket, put all your greens in there. It's a really fun thing to do. And it gets your children involved also.
Well, tell me about this bow here.
Okay. Well, this bow here, Rhonda, I'm making this wreath for my daughter's bedroom door, and she loves the little country thing. So I had gone downstairs, I found a little bit of a vintage ribbon, and then a little bit of just ribbon that was bought at the store not too long ago, and also some raffia I put behind it, which also always brings in the country theme. And then a little angel that I had just tucked right in there.
That's great. Okay, we have these little clusters here I see that you've made up. What
yes.
do those consist of?
Actually, I made up a few little clusters, and again, I kind of wanted to stick with the country theme, so I had stuck in some iris pods. And then there were just some things that, again, I had found in my basement. There were, that one's attached a little bit. There were some red berries, and then also some glittered eucalyptus that I just cut up. And also, this was kind of cool. This was a little flower that I had just found roaming around down there, and I just snipped off little bits of it, so it kind of looks like a little bit of snow. So it's really kind of fun to just see what you have and use it.
That's great. Now, what if I wanted to, say, personalize my wreath? Maybe I wanted to bling it out a little bit. I'm a girl who likes bling, so how could I do that, Gail?
Okay. Well, you know what? I think that wreaths are all your personality. So whatever you like, you go gather things to put in it. Let's see, a blingy wreath. You know what you could do, Rhonda? First of all, the ribbon always sets the tone.
Okay.
You could get ribbon that was either opalescent or gold or silver or just whatever. You could get beautiful balls and just, you know, cluster a few of them together, tuck those in your wreath. Another thing that you could also do is crystals. Bling? What? How better bling than having crystals in your wreath?
Sounds pretty.
You know, they sell individual crystals. They sell crystals that come in, you know, swag type things. This one here is pearls that I have, but I also have one at home that is crystals, and you can kind of weave those in through your wreath. So
great.
Now then you would have that really kind of cool blingy wreath that you want.
All right, well, let's get started here, because I'm anxious to get this wreath going.
Okay. Well, the first thing we're going to do, again, like I said, we make little, like, bouquets, little clusters of greens, Rhonda.
Okay.
And then what we are going to do, again, your wire is already attached to your ring, so you're going to take your little cluster, you're going to lay it right on top of the ring, like this, very simple, and you're going to wrap your wire around, you know, one or two times. It's nothing
to
big.
To hold it in place?
Just to hold it in place. So, you know, actually two or three times is good.
Right.
And then again, you would take another cluster and you would take that and you would just layer that, you know, on top of the other one, but just come down a little bit from it. So you're going to be layering this all around the ring. And again, it goes so fast once you have it all prepped up and prepared.
Put your Christmas music on.
And put your Christmas music on. You know, just enjoy it. This is the time of year that it's so much fun to be able to do this extra kind of stuff. So we're just really thankful that God has given us the opportunity to be able to show you how to do this.
And there we have our beautiful Christmas wreath. Gail taught us how to make a wreath, the beautiful clusters, a beautiful bow, and it's a good thing she showed us how to make it because she took hers and ran out the door with it. But now I can make my own, and so can you. Merry Christmas from Take Two Ministries.